From the station that made country music famous, 650 AM WSM, this is a Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast.
Hi, it's Charlie Matos, and in this episode, we sit down with Easton Corbin. Easton would join us via Zoom the morning of July the 31st of 2020. We would talk about his brand new single, Turn Up. We'd also talk about his collaboration with world-famous EDM artist Lost Frequencies and a whole lot more. Enjoy our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast with Easton Corbin.
Coffee, Country, and Cody.
Billy Boy with the week off. I'm Charlie Matos. That is Eric Markham. And we are excited for new music from Easton Corbin, who is Zooming with us this morning. And you got a busy morning. You got a co-write via Zoom in about 20 minutes, and you're squeezing us in before that.
Yeah, man. That's all right. We're having a good time doing it.
Well, if this were 10 or 15 years ago, I would be bragging on my Miami Hurricanes. But the way things have gone football-wise the last decade or so for us, I am not going to give any grief to a Florida Gator as my guest this morning on Coffee, Country, and Cody.
We've been pretty fortunate, yeah, to do pretty good the last few years.
Yeah, so... you grew up in Trenton. That's, maybe a half hour from Gainesville, a little bit longer, but pretty close, right?
Yeah, it's about 45 minutes from Gainesville.
Yeah. So if music had not changed your life, what would you have done with the degree from the University of Florida? What was plan B if plan A didn't work out?
Honestly, I don't know. I'd probably be working in the agriculture industry somewhere. Uh-huh. I don't know. I grew up on a small cattle farm, and you know, I got an agriculture business degree from University of Florida, so I'd probably be, it's kind of a pretty natural fit for me. So
yeah.
I'll be working in that sector somewhere.
So when did Nashville become home? You were in your early 20s, huh?
I was, I think around 26, I think, because I remember graduating from University of Florida from around 2006, and I think I was in Nashville by October.
Okay. And how long in Music City before the folks at Mercury found you?
It was probably about a year, something okay. like that.
That's actually pretty quick in the grand scheme of things. I'm sure it felt a lot longer while you were killing time, playing writer's nights and doing stuff. But in hindsight, that's actually not bad, huh?
Yeah, in hindsight, you're right. That's pretty quick, yeah. Actually.
So one of the first things we ever heard from you on the radio was a great Rory Feek and Win Varble tune called A Little More Country Than That. First time you heard the demo on that, is that something that you said, man, that's just me. That's my song.
Yeah, well, I mean, it definitely resonated with me. I mean, that's pretty much my biography, whatever you call it. Mm-hmm. You know, that pretty much describes where I grew up. I mean, it really does.
Yeah. And to have that first single go number one, you know, there's a handful of artists who can say that, but it's a pretty cool feeling. What was the first big tour you went out on where people really started singing along with it and you realized that, oh, yeah, this is starting to take off?
You know, I mean, it's crazy because it went number one before I ever actually went out on an actual show.
Oh, wow.
I was still on a radio tour when the thing went number one.
So by the time you started playing it for people, everybody knew it.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah, wow. So Paisley would have been one of the first big tours you were out with, Brad?
Paisley was the first big tour I ever was on.
Wow. So what do you get from watching him on stage after your opening set? Because there's a guy who'd already been at it for at least a good decade or so and had a ton of hits.
Yeah. I mean, it's a new artist that you know hadn't had much experience on stage. You know, you definitely learn a lot from a guy like that, and you know how you know he works the crowd and how he entertains.
Yeah, I think the nice part about a country crowd too in an arena or an amphitheater is, for the most part, they tend to show up. They want to see everybody. You know, I've been to a lot of rock shows where, you know, the opening act, there might be 1,000 in a 15,000-seat arena, and, you know, that sound is rattling around a lot. But you probably played to a lot of folks early on, huh?
Well, it's funny, you know, when I opened for Paisley, we actually were on a thing called the water stage.
Okay.
And it was out in the parking lot.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because it was the H2O tour, and we had the water stage, so that was a little bit – that was early,
okay,
for sure.
All right. I think somebody
but
got a little –
we had a lot of people out there.
Yeah. I think somebody got a little too clever with the H2O on that tour, I think, in hindsight. Well, I love Turn Up. Tell me about that song.
Man, it's a song that I remember I came in one day, we were writing with my producer, Wade, and the NBA finals were going on, mm-hmm. and he was watching them, and I guess it was after the game. They interviewed one of the players, and one of the players was like, man, I just want to turn up. And he took that thing and brought it in. He said, man, I think that'd be a good title. And at first I was like, yeah, I don't know. I wasn't really feeling it.
Yeah.
And we came around a few writes later, and he's like, man, I still think that'd be a good title. And I said, well, let's chase it and see what happens. And sure enough, we came out with this song, and I'm glad we did.
Let's chase it right now on 650 AM WSM and Circle Television. Easton Corbin and Turn Up.
Turn off your lights, turn off your phone, turn off your homework week. Tune out the fast, tune in the slow, getting ready to roll.
That is Turn Up, brand new from Easton Corbin, available wherever you download or stream music. Easton zooming with us this morning on Coffee, Country, and Cody. Billy Boy, by the way, is taking the week off. He said, oh, man, I hate to miss Easton Corbin, so tell him hi. I always love working with him on the Opry stage, and can't wait to have you in studio, and we're allowed to have people back in studio.
Yeah, man, I can't wait. Yeah.
So what has life been like for you since mid-March?
Well, it's probably like everybody else, ready to get back on the road, you know, miss being out there with the fans and playing live music, you know?
Yeah. We mentioned when we started the chat, though, that you've got a co-write coming up on Zoom in about 10 minutes or so. Has this time given you more time to do more of that than sometimes life on the road would afford you?
We've definitely had a lot of time to do that, but I'm ready for some human interaction.
I hear you.
You know, getting back with people and there's something to the human element that makes it better.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Yeah. Yeah. You can imagine a virtual response, but there's nothing like seeing people sing along or clapping along or just seeing the faces of folks smiling along. Right.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm definitely a social guy. So this staying at home stuff, I'm ready to get back at it.
So you enjoy your time at the merch table after a show, really getting to chat with people and take photos and meet and greet?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's one of those things where you kind of sometimes you take it for granted, and then when something like this happens, it's like, man, I'd give anything to be out there just, you know, hanging out with everybody.
Well, when I heard Turn Up for the first time, I said, man, we got to have Easton on the show. And then they said, hey, well, you know, he's got another new thing out too with a world famous EDM artist. And I'm like, electronic dance music and Easton Corbin? Nah, wait a minute. So please tell me about this partnership with Lost Frequencies and a song called One More Night, which we'll hear a little bit of as we wrap this up. But I tell you, I really love the song.
Well, it's funny, and it's funny you say that. You know, I thought the same thing when I first heard Are You With Me? Uh-huh. You know, he took that song, which was a song of mine, and remixed it into an EDM thing. And uh-huh. When I first, you know, somebody told me, he's like, man, I just heard your song Are You With Me on an EDM thing. I'm like, what? And I'm like, crazy. And but then when I heard it, I was like, man, that's actually really, really cool.
Yeah.
And so he wanted to do something else kind of in that vein, but you know, he wanted to work with me on it. Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, man, he done a real, really cool job on, you know, Are You With Me? I thought it sounded really cool. And I was like, well, why not? So they played me the song and I was like, well, that's a cool song. And you know, it's a great opportunity to be a good ambassador for country music. Cause you know, that's a whole nother world. And, yeah, I like the song, and he did a great job on it, and it sounds great.
Yeah, what I love is it's different, but it's accessibly different. It's not so crazy that it doesn't even sound like you. It's still, I mean, it's just really catchy, you know. So
it's one of those deals where, you know, it's still my voice on there.
Yeah,
we didn't do anything to make that any different. I recorded that just as I would record any other song.
Yeah. Well, thank you for your time this morning. It's been great visiting with you, and we cannot wait to have you back in studio at some point. Heck, we can't wait to have anybody back in studio at some point.
Yeah, no kidding.
All right, you got 6 minutes to prepare. Go write a hit song at 10 o'clock, okay?
Yeah, hey, thank y'all so much. I appreciate it.
All right, that is Easton Corbin. This is Easton and Lost Frequencies with a little bit of One More Night as we go to the break on Circle Television.
Thanks for listening to our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. Our program director at WSM Radio is J. Patrick Tittle. Our digital producer is Haley Hall. Marketing and promotions director is Amanda Cannon. And I'm Charlie Mattos. If you like what you've heard, make sure you subscribe so you never miss an episode. And leave us a review on iTunes. It really does help new people find the show.